In this video, you'll see part one of how to create a container product on AWS Marketplace. By listing your container product on AWS Marketplace, you can grow your customer base, protect your product's intellectual property, and improve efficiency and reliability. This video is part one of a three-part series. The advantages to listing container products on AWS Marketplace include access to a vast customer base, integrated billing, reporting, license management, a trusted Amazon ECR registry, deployment automation, and more. AWS Marketplace offers sellers a number of flexible pricing models and deployment options for container-based products. This is the process for creating a new container product in AWS Marketplace. In this video, we'll focus on the highlighted steps. As a prerequisite, we need to register as a seller in AWS Marketplace, so let's do that now. First, we'll provide our legal business name. Next, we'll accept the terms and conditions, specify our plans, and sign into the AWS Marketplace Management Portal. Now that we've registered as a seller, let's add a public profile with a logo that will be seen by potential buyers. We are now able to publish free products on AWS Marketplace. To activate paid pricing models, we would need to set up our payment information as well. For the purposes of this example, let's move on to creating a container product. We can create a new container product using the Assets menu on the portal. Let's copy the product ID, code, and public key for later use. Next, we'll upload a container product load form and fill it out. The container product load form is a spreadsheet that contains information about the product, including pricing details. Let's begin by pasting in the product ID we copied earlier. Next, we'll enter a product title. As we enter information, a pop-up displays the unique specifications for the selected field. The email address we enter here will be used by the AWS Marketplace team to contact us if there are any questions or issues with our publishing request. Next, we'll enter the URL for the end-user license agreement for our product. We also have the option to establish geofences by specifying countries to include or exclude. For our purposes, let's skip this step to make the product available in all countries. Next, let's take a look at our different pricing options. We need to take care when selecting a pricing model because not all pricing model changes are supported, and all requests to change models must be reviewed and approved by the AWS Marketplace team. First, let's go over the hourly pricing model. Hourly pricing will charge the buyer for each hour the product is used. Billing is per second with a 1 minute minimum. The hourly price must also be specified. Or we can add a long-term contract price that provides buyers with a discount for committing upfront. Next, let's take a look at the usage pricing model. With this custom metering model, customers pay only for what they use. We can select from several different usage categories or select the generic units option if we want a custom category. For the purposes of this demo, let's define three dimensions for this custom usage pricing: admin user, software manager user, and end user. Each type of user will be charged at a different rate. Dimension names cannot be changed once they're set. The dimension description is what the buyer will see when they go to the product page. Next, we'll set the rate for each dimension. We'll charge admin users $20, software manager users $10, and end users $5 for each unit of usage. Finally, let's review the contract pricing model, in which the buyer is billed upfront or by a payment schedule that we define. Similar to the usage model, we can choose the category that best describes our product's pricing. The pricing category appears to customers on the AWS Marketplace website. Next, we need to indicate whether this is a tiered pricing offer or a non-tiered offer that allows for purchase of multiple dimensions. We'll set it to false, indicating that this is a tiered offer. The API name is the name that should appear in the license generated by the buyer's AWS License Manager account. The display name is the customer-facing name of the dimension that will be displayed on the product detail and procurement pages of the AWS Marketplace website. It cannot be changed once the listing is public. The customer-facing description of a dimension provides additional information, such as the capabilities that the specific dimension provides. Let's enter contract rates for different durations, and then create another dimension for an enhanced tier with a greater discount. The dimension quantity of any contract offer will be 1. If we want to allow non-tiered or multiple purchases of each dimension, we can set the value of the Allow Multiple Purchases field to True. Next, we'll save the container product load form and return to the portal. Let's upload the product load form. Our request will be sent to the AWS Marketplace Operations team, who will publish the product in a limited state or get back to us with any questions they have. In the next part of this video series, we'll continue the process of creating our AWS Marketplace container product. You've just seen part 1 of how to create a container product in AWS Marketplace. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.